السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح
الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين الله الذي هدانا في دين الإسلام ونحمده ونشكره ونستعينه أعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا ومن يهد الله فلا هادي له ومن يهدي فلا مضل له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وعلى كل شيء قدير ونشهد أن نبينا ومولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم إمام الرسول وخاتم النبيين وبشرى للعالمين اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه لا يوم يبعثون أما بعد يا عباد الله كما قال الله تعالى في الكتاب الكريم من سورة البقرة أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون صدق الله مولانا العظيم وبلغ رسول الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين praise be to Almighty Allah, the Lord of the universe. We thank him, we praise him, we glorify his name. This is Almighty Allah who make Islam to be so easy for us with his love. He make us to be a Muslim. Alhamdulillah for that. We are asking Almighty Allah to continue to make us a good Muslim and we go back to him. This is the Allah that deserves to be worshipped and nobody else. He's the one who knows all of our affairs. He's the one who can resolve all our affairs. We also make a thank to Almighty Allah for sending Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a rahmah for all mankind and jinn. And we are so grateful to Allah as well that he makes us to be the follower of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the seed of the Prophet and the leader of all the prophets. We are asking Almighty Allah to shower his blessing upon the noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his household, the Sahaba, the progeny, and those of us who follow the religion of Islam, or we go back to him. Today we are going to take a clue from the constitution that Allah has revealed to all mankind and jinn, which is Al-Quran al-Kareem. Our topic today is Mu'assalamat Ya Ramadan, farewell to Ramadan. We thank him that beginning we started and now it's going to an end and we are still alive. A lot of people did not start with us. A lot of people started with us, but there are no more. But we are so thankful to Allah for sparing our life. We are also asking Almighty Allah that today, the last Friday of the Ramadan, should not be our end. May Almighty Allah let us perform many, many Jummah in our lifetime. In this surah, is something we are going to continue saying. When Allah says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, he says, oh, you believe. Kutiba alaykum siyam. Fasting is prescribed for you. Kama kutiba ala ladhina min kabulikun, as I prescribed for those who are before you, we are not the only one. La'allakum tatakum, so that we may attain piety, we may attain velocity. As we know, that piety is what we have displayed from the beginning of this Ramadan until today. Because most of the things that we used to do for the fear of Allah, we abstain from it, we restrain ourselves, we discipline ourselves, we do not do it because we want to move closer to Allah. We want to elevate our iman. We want to elevate our spiritual belief. We want to elevate our position with Almighty Allah. And that is exactly what Ramadan is all about, and that is the purpose why Allah instituted Ramadan. Because we are so forgetful about our life, about our role in this world. Everybody wants to accumulate wealth, and we don't even care. But we can see that we are so much pious within ourselves to Allah, and we can see the relationship that existed among us within this period. And that is the kind of life that Allah wants us to do. If we are able to inculcate this practice for a whole month, when the Ramadan is over, we should not go back to our old ways. This is the new life that we're supposed to be continuing. Now, Allah said, Ayyamun Ma'dudat. He said, the period to fast are fixed days, either 29 days or 30 days. So that shows that whatever has the beginning must have an end. Equally, our life too has the beginning, and one day our life is going to end. So, like Allah said in Surah Al-Rahman, "Kulli shay'in fani wa yabqa wajhu rabbika sul jalali wal ikram." Everything on this earth is going to perish, is going to finish. Who is going to remain? The Almighty Allah, who has no beginning and who has no end. Now, once we know this, that one day we are not going to be on this earth, what is our preparations toward everlasting life, akhirah? What are we thinking about? Walau ista alifan sumu alifayni ba'daha wala buddha min yawmin tasiru al-qabr. No matter how we live, 1,000 years, 2,000 years, 3,000 years, we are still going back to Allah. Even though the most beloved person, Allah took him at the age of 63. Who are we? Even the Prophet Noah, who spent almost 1,000 years, he went back to Allah. Definitely we are going one day. But it is this life that we are going to prepare for that. And that's why I say we are more to call the money and force to come in and hide in such doing the Lord. Whatever we do in good deed, Allah is reserving it, is saving it for us. With interest, not interest of this world, but interest of good deed, reward from Almighty Allah. As we also know that Shahru Ramadan lati unsila fihi al-Quran huda linnas wa bayyinat min al-huda wal furqan. It is this month that Allah revealed Quran al-Karim to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a guardian to guide us on the right way and from the right and the wrong, so we know what we are doing. We know what is lawful, we know what is unlawful. We know what is halal, and we know what is haram. And how do we make judgment among ourselves? So that we deal with ourselves with sincerity. And also, there's no any kind of injustice that prevails among us. No oppression. We love one another. And we have to say things, the way we see things, that's the only way we are going to make judgment. So that's it. And it is this month Now, in this Quran, that Allah told us how to worship Him. It is this way Allah said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنْسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I did not create you, human being and jinn, but to worship Me. That's our primary goal in this world. And it's also the same Quran that Allah said, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَّوْقُوتًا. The time that we are going to pray to Almighty Allah, Allah give us the time. How we are going to pray. The Prophet ﷺ has given us the way we are going to pray. And we are following the same thing. Alhamdulillah. And we can see that the five pillars of Islam was constituted in the Holy Quran. Shahadatun la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah wa iqamis salat wa itai zakat wa sawm ramadan wa hajjul bayt liman istata'a ilayhi sabila. All these five pillars of Islam is what we display in this month of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah. May Allah accept all our acts of ibadah, all our supplications. In this month, we can see that we congregate more in the masjid than any other day, apart from the month of Ramadan. Why? Because we want to attain the highest reward from Allah. We know that congregational prayer is more rewarding. Salatul Jama'at afdalu min salatil mufrada. Praying in congregation has more reward than when you pray alone. Inasmuch as we create time to come to Zuhri prayer, Asri prayer, Maghrib prayer, Isha'i prayer, in Jama, and Fajr prayer as well. Let us continue the same thing. We don't have to desert the masjid when the Ramadan is over. This is what Allah wants. No matter what, we find a way to come because we want to attain the maximum profit, maximum reward from Almighty Allah. That's also to be able to continue. You know. So all our zakat, nawafil that we're doing, qiyamul layl, listening to the tafsir, all those things now should not end because Ramadan is over. Our Quran now should not be a decoration in our homes until the next year Ramadan before we pick it out. Quran is something that we have to read on a daily basis. We can download it on our app, on our phone, and when we go into, instead of, you know, listening to social media, that's going to corrupt us, make us to commit sins, and all those now we can move away. And also, when we read one verse from Allah and we understood it and we practice it, it's a big reward. May Allah continue to soften our mind. As we are doing this now, we know that we encourage our youth now, our kids now to fast. We have to continue to encourage them and to continue to do their regular prayers when the Ramadan is over. May Almighty Allah make this month much more rewarding for us. May Almighty Allah don't deny us the benefit of it. May Almighty Allah be inheritor of this life and the hereafter. Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala ashrafil mursalin. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa ala inda yumi yubasun. Amma ba'd. Qala Allahu ta'ala fil Qur'ani al-Karim, man salladhi yukridu Allahu qalidan hasana wa yudu'ifahu Allahu adi'afan kathirat wallahu yabusidu wa yabusitu wallahu wa ilayhi turja'un. Sadaqallahu mawlana al-azim. Now, Allah now is challenging us in the same constitution that Allah has given to us. Allah said, "Man salati, you create a law called an hasana." Allah said, "Ooh, who is going to loan me a beautiful loan?" Allah has provided for every one of us. And we know that in Ramadan, that's where we exhibit generosity. And that is the third pillar of Islam, as zakat. Zakatul fuluz. Your money that you put in a bank for a whole year that you not touch it. Did you purify that money by taking 2.5% of that money and give it to charity? Did we do it? We don't. Most of us just counting, oh, I have 500,000, 300,000, or 1 million. I'm now a millionaire. That's what we are celebrating. But that money we accumulated or put away, did we take our duty, which is zakat, zakat al-fulus? It's not only the money in the bank, anything that we have, even though those who are selling produce, those who are farmers, they still have to take. But majority of us now, we work in the corporate world. We put in the stock, we put money in 401k, we put money away. And this money is not the money that we're spending every day. It's not we're spending every month. Any money you put away for a whole year, you did not spend that money, you did not use that money, you did not touch that money is due for zakat. If we don't know, we are knowing now, and then we have been hearing this not the first time, it's not a new thing. We need to do. Because the money we put away, and we don't spend in the course of Allah, that money is not ours. If we drop there today, somebody else is going to take over the money. But Allah is now asking now that who is going to loan me a beautiful loan that I'm going to put onto his credit in multiple folds, multiple times. He knows what he gave to individual. We cannot deny, we can deceive ourselves, but we cannot deceive Allah. You can deceive me, you can deceive one another, but you cannot deceive Allah. You know what you have, you know what you put away. How much have you spent of this money in the course of Allah? How much have you spent for the poor? How much have you spent for the needy? The orphans, the miskin, how much have you spent on them? In the madrasa, how much have you spent? To build masjid, how much have you spent out of this money? Remember that the food you eat that's the one belongs to you. The one in your refrigerator is not yours. The money you spend, that is your money. The one you counting, that is in your bank account, saving account, checking account, whatever you put away, that money is not yours. Because the moment in Allah, in Dawil Musa, Allah knows when he's going to recall you. The moment Allah recall you, all what you left behind, you have no control. They can spend it the way they want. But what is your reward when you go back to Allah? Anything that they do behind you, if Allah wants, you get reward. Because when you are alive, what did you do? What is your own decision when you are in control of this money? Allah said, remember that all of you are coming back to me. And if you give your money to Allah, what is the reward that you're going to get? Allah said, Yaghfiru lakum sunubakum, I'm going to forgive you your sin. Fayudhilakum jannatin tajri min tahtiha al-anhar, and I'm going to put in a paradise that the water is flowing beneath. Allah, I said, he's going to put you in a beautiful mansion. And that is the highest reward from Allah. If you give 1,000, Allah said, I'm going to multiply it. Why do you think Abu Bakri, radiallahu anhu, was never down in his financial dealing? He spent. If Umar tried to compete with him, he cannot. Because whatever he has, he was giving everything to Allah. And when he said, this money, I couldn't do much. The one wanted to do it. So the Prophet said, don't give charity. And you see how your income will drop. And you say, I know, I cannot do without that. But we can't. What are we going to do? What legacy are we leaving for our children, for our kids? As we know that this masjid, they feel this place is too congested now, it's too compacted now, they are now moving for a bigger place. And what the Prophet said about this? Mom banu alillahi masjidan banu Allah bayt fil jannah. If you build a house for Allah in this world, Allah will build a mansion for you اليوم القيامة. What is the legacy that we want to leave in terms of propagating Islam? What are we going to do with all the money that we have? Remember, we came with nothing, and we shall go with nothing. But what will go with us? It's our good deeds. Your salat, your zakat, and your relationship with your fellow human being, whether Muslim or non-Muslim. All other things, you are going to leave it behind. Your house is not going with you, even though your children are not going with you. Your wife, they are not going with you. Your certificate you acquired, none of them will be buried with you. So what do we do from the effort that we make? Some will be thinking, oh, I struggle, I work. You are not the only one that struggle, but Allah make you, your struggle to be a success for you. And don't let that one enter into your head and say you are not going to spend something for the cause of Allah, or you are not going to help any other fellow human being. No condition is permanent. You have to live. Allah gave it to you as a custodian. He wants to see how you manage it. And tomorrow, he may take it away from you. That's why the prophet said, "La tu sirisha matata biyahika wa yuafiyahu lohu wa yabutaliyaka." A poor person today, a cleaner today, don't laugh at that person. Don't underrate that person. Don't ignore that person. Don't belittle that person. Allah may take you away from your position and put him in your position. Everything in this life is temporary. Our life too is temporary. And if you go to Surah Al-Munafiqun, this is what Allah is telling us, that when you spend your money for me, this is a reward that you are coming to. And like Prophet said, that two people are going to regret in the day of Qiyamah. The person who is spending in the cause of Allah will be regretting, if I had known, I would have spent more when I was alive. And those who are stingy, they will be regretting, if I had known, I would have spent whatever I have for the sake of Allah. But it's too late. Let me go back now and make amends. It's not going to happen. And this is what Allah is telling us in Surah Al-Munafiqun. He said, "Wa'anfiku mimma razaqnakum min qabli an ya'tiya ahadukum al-maut." He says, spend whatever you have now when you are able, when you can run up and down, when you can make decisions, when you are still conscious of your life. "Qabla an ya'tiya ahadukum al-maut," until before the death comes to you. Don't wait at that time. That is where you want to spend. See, you know at the point of your death, that money you're spending has no barakah, has no reward, because you know you have no choice. And that money is not going to help you. It's like some people too, when they're telling them about embracing Islam, they don't want to. But when they know they are at the point of no return, they say they want to take shahada. What kind of shahada are you doing? You think you are going to fool Allah? No. When you are able, they are telling you, what did you do? You refused. They didn't take it. Why did you want to spend our money? Allah is the one who creates a human being. He's the one that creates shaitan. He says, "Shaitan ya'idukum lifakira wa ya'murukum bilfahsha'i wallahu ya'idukum magfira minhu wa fadlan wallahu wasi'un 'alim." It is the shaitan who should be telling you, why do you have to give your money to Allah? So you are going to become poor. Don't do it. If Allah gives this money to you, just continue to count and continue to invest that money. But Allah said, if you spend your money for me, all the sin that you have committed, that donation will wipe it out. Allah will also increase you in daraja. Allah sees everything. Allah knows everything. So, my brothers, we shouldn't allow Shaitan to
derail us from what Allah has prepared for us. And we're doing this now. We don't have guarantee until we do it to the end. According to the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, see how many people that have been working, praying, doing everything all his life, very close to his end, Allah just tests him. And he failed the test. He said, I don't want to worship Allah. I don't want to do anything. Why shall I do this injustice to me? Why will this thing happen to me? I pray, I give zakat, I do everything. Why should I be doing? Therefore, I'm not doing. Shortly, the death comes, and look at how he was serving Allah all his life. It just ends. And he also refers again. How many people that you see them, they are so thuggish, they are so wicked, they are so barbaric, they do everything. But all of a sudden, they just show remorse. And they came to the man and said, I want to take shahada. And you see them doing this maybe 3 months, 6 months, a year, for 2 years, now they die. The day they've taken the shahada, all these things have been wiped away. But my brothers and sisters, I want us to seal our Ramadan, this Ramadan, with a generosity for the sake of Almighty Allah. Give me 5 minutes. After we finish our prayer, don't run away. If you know you are running away, see the authority of this masjid, the executive. Whatever you can give it to them. That money we need to complete. We need construction money for the Queen's Ozone Park masjid that they are doing over there. Let's use this is our last Friday of this Ramadan. Let me quickly give you, I know it's about time now to pray. I said it before, I'm going to repeat again. This is not time of Umar, this is not time of Abu Bakr. This is not the time of Abdurrahman bin Auf. This is our own time. My Masjid Rahmatullah in Staten Island, it cost us $520,000. And at that time, we were able to put down only $100,000 as deposit. And then we make arrangement with the owner. He's a Jewish person. That we thought within 3 years we should be able to raise that money. But in three years, how much did we raise? Only 50,000. Where are we going? The contract is over. But we continue to make our monthly payment. We just pray that nothing happens to this man, because if it happens to him and the children took over, they will say, well, we elapsed in our agreement, therefore they want to take over. But we have faith in Allah. And Allah just sent one person. After the prayer, he called me and said, okay, I said, yeah, what happened? He said, meet me, I want to see you. I said, I work at 4 to 12. He said, okay, I'm going to pick you up. He came to pick me up. He said, how much do you owe for the masjid? I said, this is the amount we owe. He said, okay, call the owner and let us make arrangements. I couldn't believe it. I said, okay, let me talk to the executive and also the other. They talk, they make arrangements, they work. Guess what? 2 weeks after we completed the deal, this man passed away. Do you see the deal? Do you see what's happened to him? Because nobody knows. And the same thing I'm asking for us now. Next year is not guaranteed. Next week is not guaranteed. Even though the end of today is not guaranteed for everyone. My brothers and sisters, all what we need today, I'm not going to ask you too much. But if we can get beyond that, alhamdulillah, I know we can do it. We are not going to raise more than minimum of 20,000 after this salat. So Allah will reward every one of us. Allah will bless every one of us. Allah will make sure that our good deed, we are going to do something fantastic before we go back to Allah, and Allah will make because of that now and bless us in this life and hereafter. ربنا لا تجعلنا بعد ما دعوتنا وابنا نكون على الهام ربنا اعطنا في الدنيا حسنا وفي الاخره حسنا واقنا عذاب النار اقول لك هذه حسنا واقيم الصلاه so let us pray and after that now we make our salat we make dua and then we raise this money inshallah ta'ala so please move forward turn off your cell phone and let us stay closer together According to the authority, mask is still required as far as the mosque is concerned.
So, let's accommodate ourselves, inshallah.
Please let us accommodate ourselves.
Let's accommodate ourselves. Give more room.